Hello everyone, my name is Santosh and today I am going to take a session on specific topic in AWS EC2 services. I am going to talk about launching an instance in Amazon Web Services cloud platform. So before we move ahead, let us understand what is EC2. EC2 or Elastic Compute Cloud is one of the popular AWS service. This service is also known as infrastructure as a service, which is provided by multiple cloud platform, for example AWS, Azure, Google Cloud and so on. The service helps you deploy virtual machine on Amazon Web Services cloud platform. This service saves a lot of investment that a customer needs to spend on the hardware. Instead, the same amount he or she can spend to launch and run the various services and instances as per the need. With the help of EC2 service, we can launch as many or as few VMs as per our need. It is also very helpful as you can scale the hosted server or the workstation depending on your need. For example, let's say that you need more computing power on the server that you're working upon. In that case, with just few clicks, you can get additional RAM and virtual CPUs, which makes your task very easier. Before we start the hands-on, let us understand with the help of this diagram as what happened during the launch of an instance. As you see in the diagram, a user can access the instance over the internet. But to do so, the user should have the required credentials and the permission to access the instance over the internet. The required credentials can be achieved via the public and private key for a Linux instance, and for the Windows instance you can get the same thing, you can achieve the same thing by the username and password. The required permission is achieved via the security group, which helps you manage the inbound and outbound traffic over the instance. The security group is very much similar to the host-based firewall, which helps you understand what can be allowed and what will be blocked on your instance. Let us see a very simpler diagram depicting what I have just mentioned before. So here, as you see, the user is trying to access this Linux instance over the internet, and you have this security group which allows or denies the traffic for the Linux instance. So in this hands-on, we are going to cover how to launch a Linux instance in the AWS console, how to access the instance using the key pair, and how to start, stop, delete or terminate a VM in the AWS cloud platform. To register for AWS free tier account, this would be very helpful for development and testing needs. Okay, so once you register, quickly log into AWS Management Console and click on the EC2 services, which can be found on the top when you click on services under the compute category. On the EC2 dashboard, click on launch instance to launch an instance. The configuration which you see here will take you through the various steps in launching an instance. This is a very helpful guided steps which will make your task very much easier. So the first step, you need to choose an AMI or basically an Amazon machine image which is a template that contains the required software configurations like operating system, the applications that you want to host on the instance, and make your task very easier to launch an instance. So in this case, I'm going to select the Amazon Linux E2 AMI, one more thing which you need to observe, that this is a free tier eligible. Selected. The next step talks about choosing an instance type. So instance type is based on the amount of memory or virtual CPU that should be assigned to a specific instance. I'm selecting the T2.micro as it is free tier eligible and click on next. There are multiple configuration that you need to perform on this step, but as of now just leave it default. I'm going to explain the things further and I'm going to explain the things in the other sessions. One thing that you have to select is you can choose the subnet. So subnet is basically a part of the network where you want to host this instance. You have three options. You can either leave as default without any preference, but or either you can choose the different availability zone that is available here. So in my case, I see South 1A, South 1B and South 1C. I would just randomly select a South 1A and I will leave all the other configuration default. Click on next, add storage. By default, I have a root volume of 8 GB and I'm good with that. Click on next, add tag. You can add the tag if you require. And next, click on configure security group. I'm going to create a new security group called as launch VZ1. And if you see in this specific security group, we are allowing to access this instance over the port 22 from anywhere. 0.0.0/0 implies from anywhere. Click on review and launch. You can review the configuration that you just made. Everything looks fine. Click on launch. Yeah. So now once you launch, there's a need that you should be able to access the instance. To access the instance, you need to create a credential or a key pair for the same. So I'm going to create a new key pair for the purpose of this lab, and I'm going to give the key pair name as testing key pair. Click on download a key pair and then click on view instances. So as you see now, my instance is being initializing now and in the pending state. So in the meantime, let us understand how can we access this instance using the key pair. So let's open the key pair which we just downloaded. As you see, the key pair that I have downloaded is testing-keypair.pe. We are going to utilize a tool called as PuTTY to access our instance. You can download the PuTTY from the web. Just go to putty.org and download the PuTTY here. Once you download, just go on the start and search for PuTTY. So this PuTTY supports .ppk extension, but the file that we have downloaded just now is basically a .pem file. Thus we need to convert this .pem file to .ppk. So just go to start, click search for PuTTY. Below you can see a PuTTY gen. So click on this PuTTY gen, which is nothing but a PuTTY generator. Click on the conversion here and import the key which you have just downloaded. And click on save private key. After that, close the PuTTY generator. So now if you see, I have the testing.ppk, the corresponding ppk file which I'm going to utilize to access my instance. So now you open the PuTTY. Yeah, and before we move ahead, let's see what's the status of our instance. So now the instance is up and running. Now if you want to access this instance, you need, okay, before we move ahead to accessing the instance, let us see what do we have here. So if you see, we have the instance ID, we have the instance state that is running, the type t2.micro, we have a private IP assigned to this instance, we have a public IP assigned to this instance, we also have a DNS which is assigned to this instance. Apart from that, there are other various other things like VPC ID, subnet ID, AMI ID. So this is the AMI which we have selected during the while performing the steps for launching an instance, which you can see here. Okay, so now let's try connecting the instance. So we will use the public IP to connect to this instance. So let's go back to our PuTTY. And for the Amazon Linux AMI, the default username is ec2-user@ your IP address through which we're gonna access the instance. And then go to the SSH, click on auth, and on the browse, check for that PPK file which we have just recently converted from .fem. So now we have the host name and the corresponding username to access the host, and the password or the key value pair is attached in the SSH. Now click on open. So now if you see, we are able to access our instance. So if you want to check, is it the same instance that we are accessing, search for ipconfig. And if you see the IP address 172.31.46.35, which is very similar to what the IP address, private IP address that is has been assigned to this instance. So I hope you understand how to launch an instance in AWS CloudFormation. Okay, great. So moving further, let's see how to stop, terminate, or reboot an instance. So it's pretty simple. So let's move ahead. Stopping or terminating an instance can be achieved in two ways. One, checkmark the instance which you want to stop or terminate. Click on actions, go to instance state, and either click on stop or terminate. The other way is you can right click on the instance, click on instance state, and again you have the option for stop, reboot, and terminate. So let's go and terminate an instance, stop an instance. So go to instance state, stop. So once you stop an instance, no data will be lost in the root volume. But if you have any storage of FML type, which will be looking into the further sessions, that will be lost. Click on stop. So now if you see, the instance is stopping. I'm pausing the video. Okay, so now as you see, the instance has been stopped. So now to terminate the instance, again right click on the instance, go to the instance state, and click on terminate. So if you click on terminate, all the data which is stored on this instance will be lost and basically will be deleted, and you cannot access the instance again. So be sure before you terminate any instance. Okay, then click on terminate. Yeah, so hope you would have learned how to launch an instance, stop and terminate an instance. See you in the further sessions. Thank you.